It was a debate that will go down the political history as the first ever televised FDC presidential flag bearers debate. A debate that would give the candidates an opportunity to win hearts of some Ugandans and also allow the electorate decide on who the better candidate was of the two. The two candidates are three-time presidential contender, retired Colonel Dr. Kizza Besigye, and current party president, retired Major General Mugisha Muntu. The debate centered on their views on local issues such as electoral reforms and governance, to international affairs such as Uganda's standing in the region and their personalities.
It's a matter that can no longer be delayed. What needs to be done is known. It is very clear those who are supposed to do it have no motivation for doing it. It therefore must rest on the citizens of this country.
The next 6 months you must choose which path to take. Does TDA, my view is that if you use both simultaneously, it will weaken us as an opposition, because you send different signals to the population and you will neither go through an electoral process and win, nor will you succeed through civil disobedience.
It indeed brought out their leadership styles.
The only area I think where I differ with quite a number of colleagues is that whether we choose to take civil disobedience as a legitimate path of struggle, whether we choose to go through the electoral processes, organization is a critical factor. Because if you are not well organized, if you take the path of civil disobedience, you will easily be dispersed.
How to take actions? Actions these actions will be actions that are non-violent, but that assert the will of the people of Uganda to say you cannot have it the way you want, that you will organize another fraudulent election in our country. We are not going to allow you to organize another fraudulent election. Very sorry, this is what we have decided as citizens.
Thank you very much.
If you want the specific actions that we will be taking, watch this space.
The two candidates strongly differed on what both intend to do following government's failure to pass the much-anticipated electoral reforms. Besigye reiterated his earlier position on the need for electoral reforms and involuntarily made it more clearer on his possible election boycott that he had in the past hinted on.
Every candidate of TDA must fight for reforms ahead of the next elections. And the election, be cognizant of the fact that the elections are still ahead. The timetable is what you are talking about. Timetable is a result of politics. When the politics change, the timetable can change.
If we don't have the organizational capability, I know, for example, we said if electoral reforms are not carried out through parliament, we are going to shut it down. I know a number of leaders who gave those statements. The parliament was never shut down.
In what could be interpreted as a veiled attack on Besigye's work methods, Muntu condemned populist leaders for issuing threats that they cannot achieve.
As a leader, I don't like posturing, one. As a leader, I never want to give threats which cannot be carried through. I know, that the population has lost hope in us as politicians, because we like posturing. When you are a leader, never give a threat unless you are able to see it through.
Moderator, is he suggesting that the TDA is posturing?
No.
Or the compact is posturing?
No.
Because I'm asking whether he's committed. I'm asking whether he's committed not only about his position, but the position of TDA, the position of the Citizens Compact, whether he's committed to those positions, or whether he's now saying those positions are posturing.
I am concentrating on building our organizational capabilities, so when we review and say, let's take this path or that path, that whichever path we choose, we successfully execute it.
The two leaders, however, agreed on the foreign policy concerning the country's deployment in South Sudan and the current leadership crisis in Burundi and South Sudan. They also seem to agree that the incumbent President Yoweri Museveni has served his purpose after nearly 3 decades in power.
What he's doing right is obviously to suppress the rights of others. That's the only reason he's been there for 29 years.
I think if he had left off at the time when the term limit of the presidential term limit, if he had left off at that point, I think there are a number of things for which he would have been credited for. But when he removed the term limits, he has literally undermined all that.
And on what makes them better than the other?
Bottom line is that you must have support. And I consider that I have demonstrable support. Support that has been galvanized over the last many years.
He's a good candidate. There's no doubt about that. In the last three elections, are not for him as an individual. Actually, they carry over from the support of Dr. Semogere.
The fate of the two candidates lies with 1,000 delegates who will decide who is the better of the two to face off with others for the position of the joint opposition presidential candidate under the Democratic Alliance. Whoever is chosen on September 2nd could tussle it out with President Yoweri Museveni for the highest office. So, will it be Mugisha Muntu who will have a first shot at the presidency, or Besigye a fourth aim? Sheila Nduhukire, NTV.